Okay, welcome students. Till now, whatever we have discussed about the principles of management, I am very sure that by now you all have realized that the principles of management are the helping tools for managers. Correct? So, actually, they provide insights to managerial behavior. And it influences managerial practices also. All the management gurus, whosoever have given the different principles of management, actually they have continuously analyzing all managerial activities and their results to frame principles, which can be used by managers under repetitive or similar type of circumstances. So we can say that management principles enable managers to fulfill their tasks and responsibilities most effectively and efficiently. Or we may say proper understanding of management principle is very necessary and helpful for managers, as these principles act as guidelines for managerial activities. By practicing principles, managers can avoid various mistakes while dealing with people in the organization. So now let us talk about the different, what are the significance of principles of management? Why it is, you know, these are the key words which you must note down. A, it is derived, means the significance of this derives from their utility. It is useful, it provides useful insights to managerial behavior. It influences managerial practices. It fulfills the task and responsibilities. It is helpful in taking and implementing decision. And everything worthwhile is governed by an underlying principles. So now let us talk about the different significance of principles of management. The first significance of principles of management is that it provides managers with useful insights into reality. Now let us understand that what is the meaning of this word insight. Actually, insight means a deep understanding of something, and reality is what? The real world situations. So we may say that these principles of management provide useful insights, means the deep understanding of the real world situations. Next is it add to their knowledge. There means managers. So managers' knowledge is increased. Their ability becomes better. Their understanding also developed. So that in different managerial situations and circumstances, they can make the right decision. They will learn from their past mistakes. So it is helpful in that aspect also. And they need not to make mistakes and then learn. So already the principles are there. So already if they have learned something from the past mistake, they can now save their time. They can conserve their time by solving those type of problems which keep on happening in the organization. Then it increases the managerial efficiency also. And they may take several examples. You know, for example, suppose a manager has to make several decisions. So some routine decision, like which keep on happening every day, and there are people, means thus their subordinate are efficient enough to manage those things. So what he will do, he will delegate that power, that authority to its subordinate, and they will take the decision related to that, and he will keep himself for the exceptional situations which will require, where expertise is required or his better utilization of time, his skill can be done for the other purpose. So that may be used as, so this gives the useful insights. This following the principles of delegation has given a manager a useful insights. Next. Second is optimum utilization of resources and effective administration. The management principles insist on planned activities and systematic organization of men and materials in the organizations. These principles are designed to get maximum benefit from the human efforts or the other resources also. Take an example. Suppose scientific principles suggest to cut down the wasteful movements and setting up of a standard time to complete a particular task. By saving time, energy, and efforts, activities can be made economical and result in maximum utilization of resources. So that is being discussed here as optimum utilization of resources and effective administration. Now I must explain this word optimum before we go further. But before that, let us understand it that in the organization, both human and material resources are what? Limited. So we need to utilize it properly. Then they have to be put to optimum use. I would be discussing it, the meaning of this word optimum, so that the things become very clear to you. Optimum means that resources should be put to use in such a manner that they should give maximum benefit with minimum cost. Or we can foresee the cause and effect relationship of their decision and actions. No trial and error approach. You cannot say that I will learn by making mistake. No, you have to utilize the available resources at the optimum level. Managerial power is used with due discretion. You cannot just do the wasteful activities. And it will limit the boundary of managerial discretion so that their decision may be free from personal prejudices and bias. Now this optimum word I have used many times. Now let us understand it. Optimum means the most favorable situation or level for anything, for growth, for reproduction or success. Now you can see there is this picture of ball is there and there is a ball on it. So if you see this kind of shape of the ball is there, and we keep this ball just little bit this side. No, I move it, suppose this side. What will happen? The ball will fall. And if the ball is just kept this side, it will fall immediately. So what is required? There is one point only. This is the optimum point. If you keep exactly here only, then only ball will be there. Otherwise it will fall. So this is optimum point. Or we can take a diagram also to understand it. See here, you know, optimum is not minimum and it is not maximum also. So when I say optimum utilization, it is not maximum utilization. Like a machine, I can run for all 24 hours, but it will not work for a longer period of time if I do so. So I cannot utilize it for maximum time. I need to utilize it for optimum time. Suppose in 24 hours, if I'm using it for 8 hours, it will work efficiently. So the optimum time or optimum utilization of that machine would be what? 8 hours. So you see, this is minimum. Here the temperature is minimum and the growth rate is also minimum. So this is not the point where we should work. And here the temperature is maximum, but the growth rate is also lowest. So here temperature is not too much, but growth rate is at its highest point. So that would be the point where we can say that this is the optimum level of it. So the word, if optimum is clear, you would be able to understand it very nicely. So just let me once again show you. optimum utilization of resources and effective administration. So if you are utilizing your resources at optimum level, you would be in a position to provide effective administration. That is the point here which we need to talk about. Now the third is scientific decision. Management principles are based on facts. These are thoughtful and these can be justified. So it is not that I thought so, I have taken this decision. It depends on my mood. If I'm happy, I will take the decision accordingly. If I'm sad, I will take the no, this you cannot do. So principles of management are based on facts, thoughtful and justifiable. Or you may say managers have to take number of decision every day. So they need to access the resources of organization very carefully so that the appropriate decision can be taken by using the available resources in best possible manner. The management principle enable the managers to approach various problems systematically and scientifically. So you are seeing here that if scientific decisions are in the management principle, have the scientific decisions, it is the importance of it. So it will help in thoughtful decision making. It timely, realistic, and subject to measurement and evaluation. You can measure it. You can evaluate whatever this decision you are taking. It emphasizes logic, not the blind faith that I believe so. That's why I have taken. No, it is free from bias or the prejudice. Objectives assessment of the situation, and then you are making the decision. So the third point is that management principles are scientific decisions. Next is it is meeting changing environment requirement. We know that business environment is dynamic environment. It keeps on changing. It is modified to meet changing requirement. So every businessman, has to make changes in the organizations also according to changes taking place in the business environment as it is dynamic. So management principles train the managers in implementing the changes in right direction and at right level in the organization. Although management principles are relative and general guidelines, yet by modifying these principles, changes can be made in the organizations. As nowadays, what is happening? Some companies are outsourcing their non-core activities. You have studied this in your class 11. Business process outsourcing, BPO, KPO. So these things are being talked about here. So hope this point is clear now. Meeting changing environment requirements. Next is fulfilling social responsibility. There was a complete chapter in your class 11, social responsibilities of business. And we know that while we were discussing the objectives of the management, we discussed that there are three objectives of management: organizational, personal, and social objectives. So every manager has to fulfill the social responsibilities. A business is creation of society and makes use of resources of society. So it must do something for society by performing some social responsibilities. Management principles not only act as guideline for achieving organizational objective, but these principles also guide the managers to perform social responsibilities. Like the principles of fair remuneration, it insists on adequate salary to employees and take care of interest of employees also. So someone is talking about the equity today. It does not apply to wages alone. It should be in other department, other decision also. So value to the customer, care for the environment, dealings with business associate, it all will come under the preview of this principle. We have so many examples that how business takes social responsibility. Some of you can write by yours. Then the last point is about management, training, education and research. Why these principles are significant? Because it helps in management training, education and research also can be done in this. The management principle focus on scientific judgments and logical thinking. So as a result, these principles act as base of doing research and development in management studies, as these principles provide organized body of knowledge to perform research work and generate more and more knowledge. So they have provided new ideas, imagination and base for research and development. So this is being talked about. Like professional courses such as BBA, MBA also teach these principles as part of their curriculum. All the management institute take aptitude test, and these tests are based on what? Management principles only. So taking these 7 points into consideration, 6 points, sorry, 6 point, we may say that management principles are, these are the significance of the principles of management. Thank you.